The main issues around resources, as most people have gathered, are that they're getting increasingly hard to extract in good quality. It's costing more to extract resources. The current troubles in the fracking industry in the oil sector are that the price of oil is volatile and is currently low and is well below the cost of extracting this sort of oil. So it's not that the resources aren't there, it's just that the cost, either the energy cost or the financial cost of extracting them, is becoming very difficult to live with. Food prices, commodity prices are fluctuating a great deal, but are at significantly higher levels than they were in the period up to about 2002. So this squeezes spending in the economy. I might just add that the debt overhang, the amount of indebtedness in the world, also squeezes people's spending power. So that you've got resource questions, both right through from the customer, right through to the supplier, which makes it more problematical to deliver cheap materials, cheap energy, and cheap credit, actually. If you don't have all those three running, it's very hard to run a linear economy, because the linear economy depends on cheap energy, cheap materials, and cheap credit to get the throughput. So all of those are up for question. Most indicators are that the biodiversity is in decline all over the place. The ecological services that are provided by the living world or the natural world, everybody's known these are crucial to the survival of both the social and economic systems. But they're not costed in at the moment in either our understanding of them or in fact in the prices that we apply to resources which are extracted from the natural world or from the services which the living systems provide. We don't factor them in at the moment. And we need an economic system that does, in a systems way, factor these sorts of things in. September 2008 taught us many things. And one of the most important was that a financial system which is unstable accelerates boom and bust in the economy. So although it came after a period of relative moderation and calm, the level of destruction of assets and wealth in that period was almost unprecedented since the 1930s. So this really rocked the economy on its heels, and it required more intervention in terms of stimulus than for example, America had spent on all its previous adventures abroad in the last 50 years. So that's really remarkable. The financial system almost crashed the entire economy.